All right, y'all, I'm back out here at the honey hole again. Man, my friend Mike, he's the one that turned me on to this. It's on his mail route. And he had came out here once before I did and caught some shell crackers and stuff. But we out here today at that same spot I was at the other day when I was catching them. So we're going to give it a go again. Today, I changed my rig. So instead of my lose speed spin, today and my ugly stick, instead I got my Scientific Angler 9-foot rod. It's a 5/6 weight, if any of y'all know fly rods, and I'm using my Mitchell Advocate. So we're gonna see what we do. I'm using pretty much the same setup except for my line today. Instead of braid, I'm using Mr. Crappy High Viz 8-pound. Say what now?
It's a keeper.
You done caught one already? Yeah. Already. Look at you. Yeah, you can keep. Yeah, shoot. Yeah.
10 pounds. Ain't gonna look 10 inches.
Since I got my long rod, look here. Oh my God! I didn't even move it. I didn't even move it, bro. My float just started going under. I just let it sit there. This rod is so limber, it's so easy to, you gotta actually put a little effort into your hook set on this. I just went to pull him out. Didn't have a good hook set. At one point down here, every cast, I was just like.
Yeah. Made me throw out my hook.
No, you just gotta come along that vegetation. Oh man. See, you gotta be ready. I'm glad I bought my longer rod today. Okay. This triple tail is getting a lot of action with minimum work. I had one down here broke my line, and then up here where we always go at the first spot that man, I had one up there. That sucker, man, it might have been a nice bass because that sucker ran like a freight train. And next thing I know, my drag went one time, went, and then all of a sudden my line just snapped. There he is. That's the first one, y'all. Mike already caught one of his first casts, too. Thank you, Lord. So they still hitting down here. I'm hoping I catch the one that's got my jig in his mouth from the other day. I have had that happen before.
Yeah.
Back home in Alabama, I missed the fish before. Oh, well, didn't miss him, but my line got broke on one. And I've been back to the spot before and come back a couple days later and caught the fish that broke my freaking line. I was using like 2-pound test because we was fishing an area where it wasn't no stumps and stuff, but it was like this red mud, kind of red sand bottom, and they was in there, and it was a few rock piles, so it was a pretty clear area to fish. You didn't hang up hardly at all, but man, I mess around and hook a real slab, boy. And that 2-pound line, he won the battle that day. I bought my cooler today to put him in. I ain't fooling with that stringer because that basket. When I had my basket down here the other day, I got tired when I was carrying it out of here.
Ain't that me?
I tell you, I don't know if it was the combination of work that day, man, or what. I just felt so tired when I got home. You gonna end up getting down there and get to a point to where almost every cast, you come through the right spot, almost every cast, them suckers will get it. this short lining. And I be catching crappie on this short lining. It be throwing me off, man. Just like when we used to wade the lake back home. Mm-hmm. Bruh, sometimes you be in this, we got this one over there close to, across the other side of the road from the spot where I first took you, where you had failed that day in your waders.
Yeah.
On the other side of the road, the main road, where that one big, that big pipe go to the main lake.
Right.
Man, me and my cousin was out there, bruh, and we was wading. We literally, every time we would get ready to pull our jig out of the water, no more than 5 feet in front of us, we were getting bit. Just like, it was ridiculous. And that day I missed so many of them, I had to just take my float off. Cause they were short lining. It's a lot of sticks over here though on this side. Went without a float, Mike. Oh, you got worms on there.
That's a float, yeah.
Dang, bro, you got up in that dang brush over there. But I think I lost my jig. Yeah. Yeah, that one will keep everything in here that you're gonna catch. Most of them around 9 inches.
This one keep?
Yeah. He'll make a sandwich. He'll definitely make a sandwich. Hey, hey. Yeah, no problem. The guys that was in the boat is here. All right, y'all. I had to go and move my truck for the gentleman that has the gate access, but the good thing is he let me bring my truck in, so now we don't have to walk as far. Oh, all right, let's see if we can get back to catching.
So you said he laid it to Chris, Alby?
No, Chris, Thompson, Big Chris on 14.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, he's Chris's brother-in-law. Chris married his sister. She caught a couple more after I went up there, didn't you?
Yeah.
Where your line going that's on the other pole? Cause I don't see it.
Straight out.
Is it under the water?
A little bit.
I don't want to get hung on it because I like throwing down that way.
Alright, hold on.
Am I over it right now?
Nah, you good.
Okay. That's a good one. Yes, sir. Thank you, Lord. Woo. The first time you brought me down here and I went around this corner, it was a big snake. I don't know where it came from, but he was swimming across the cove, going back that way. Did you say you just saw one?
No,
oh. Up in here, but they ain't biting as good as they was Monday. Monday, you couldn't hardly throw in here and not get a bite. I probably missed more than I caught. And that's no lie. Rich have your number?
I think so.
Because I know he probably gonna call me, especially if he don't see my truck.
Let you tell him your truck in the inside.
Yeah, I'm finna tell him that here in a second. He should be getting back now. Or should already be back. Thank you, Lord. Oh boy, that mug. What's wrong with that, Joe? I like it when they bite like that. They take that mug down so deep. Ain't no missing them. Hey, you. I got a mouth full of fish slime that time. All right, let's get back to it. No. Boy, that's a big old bluegill. I'm keeping that joker. That's a titty brim right there. Boy, you hit that mug like a train. What kind of bait stuff? Eating something because you're throwing up some stuff. That's a big brim. Oh, you know what? Crappy nibbles. Yeah, they're mine. I left them down here the other day. And then when I got home, I said, man, I hope I didn't leave them. I forgot about them. Yep. Pink crappy nibbles. That day I was standing on the corner because they caught a couple of fish right here in this wide spot. So I was casting out there with some crappy nibbles. And I didn't get no bite. Thank you. When you said bait stuff, my brain started going crazy. Like, and I had forgot I had even forgot them down here. Good night in the morning. Might well fish it from over there. That's where it landed. I'll throw back over there in a second. what was that? Whatever that was a man. That mug moved every branch over there. That had to have been a big bass chasing something. And I forgot my dang real butter.
Do cappy eat worms?
Huh?
Do they eat worms?
What?
Crappy.
Yeah, they'll eat worms. Man, we used to catch crappy on worms like crazy back home when I was a kid. We'd load a 5-gallon bucket up at the creek with some worms. We'd go fishing with no bait because it was a cow pasture that the creek ran through. And we just get down there and we just flip cow patties and get worms out of them. And man, we would just put short pieces of worm on with a very, very small weight. And just kind of Carolina rig it along like we was fishing for bass. With, I mean, the smallest split shot we could get away with casting. And man, we would tear them suckers up. There's another big old grim.
I see that.
Golly.
I'm trying to cast over there.
Man, them suckers hitting harder than a cricket.
Thank you, Lord. It's a nice bluegill. Golly. Oh, no.
No, sir. I pulled a hook out in your butt, doggone. Your butt. I made it back to the water. Think I done found the brim spot.
I was catching them over there when I was on that other side.
With the jig too?
Nah, with the worm.
Oh, with the worm. Sit down on this log. There's so many sticks down here. Boy, you definitely need a minnow down here. Trying to come past these sticks and get in between them. Mm-hmm. It ain't easy because this over here, man, I want to cast over there so bad. Last time I was down here, I cast over there and I got hung up a couple of times. And that kind of dissuade me from continuing to cast over there, but I'm trying to cast close to it. I think I'm touching the bottom too over there. close to where I wanted to. I wonder what be doing that on the water. Do you see how that?
Where?
Right there, coming by that tree. Do you see how that water moving in a, just like a group? It could be the wind blowing it like that. Almost look like a school of shad or something. I bet you doggone put a float on with them worms. The way these brims hitting, you might catch some. Anxious. Did your other pole throw out over this way?
It's over there by you. Yeah.
I hope it don't.
Stop. What do y'all got?
Two or three. Brim, the good bluegill's starting to pick up though.
Are they?
Yeah.
What they hitting on?
Crappy jig. See that? Is that the worm you caught him on, Mike?
Caught one.
Y'all might get them up in these coves today. These shallows. Cause I noticed something. Yeah, I noticed something when I came down here the other day on Monday. It was way muddier than this. But the day that I seen y'all down here, there was no minnows. This vegetation hadn't started turning green yet, and there was no minnows. When I came Monday, it was minnows everywhere, and this vegetation is green. And I had a good day Monday.
How many did you get Monday?
I missed more than I caught, but I kept 12. I had a couple break my line off.
Look like that one right there wanted it pretty bad.
He got his freedom still.
What colors was you doing on Monday?
Chartreuse and black.
I thought I caught that one on a while ago.
Yeah, chartreuse and black with a little bit of fleck in it.
Yep. You catch any bass?
I caught two little bass Monday.
No size for them?
Nah, probably 7-8 inches long. Got a major tangled mess, y'all. I left the braid pole at home, man. I tangled up so much with it. And last night I put this brand new line on this one. Cause it's been sitting in the barn for so long. I ain't used it since probably about a year and a half in Alabama. I keep these long rods mostly for when I minnow fish and brush and stuff, so I can reach in there and get them easier. But
this is not a good thing.
It happens. All right, let's get back at it. Last time I was here, I didn't catch as many from this side. There go that guy that was walking. He got to be bass fishing because he back up. That cove go way back there, Mike.
That's what I'm saying. It's like he goes around that corner there.
Yeah, because I'm watching him cast. He ain't casting this way. He casting back toward the woods. I done had two really good strong bites over here. The other day when I came, I was only getting bites on this side, like right in here where all these sticks and stuff around this lock. Man, that's a big bass chasing over there.
Yeah.
That's what that is.
Bass over here.
Yeah.
I wonder how long it takes me.
That's a good question. I don't know.
You like you got plenty of fish?
Definitely that. Definitely that.
Brian, why ain't no big giants laughing?
It probably is, because the other day, I'm going to tell you, golly, I'm getting a fish right there trying to untangle my junk. The other day, bruh, when I was down here Monday, I went through probably, before I hooked into a really good one, I probably caught six or seven and missed probably just as many before I felt the fish on my line that felt like it was a really, really good fish. And that happened a couple of times because, they broke my line. Man, I don't know what's going on today with me being tangled up. I cannot stay untangled. You ain't got no water in your bucket. This is getting frustrating. I'm getting to the point now where I'm about to take me a long break.
What do you mean? Days off?
I keep getting tangled up. I don't know what the heck. Every time I turn around, I'm tangled freaking up. Like I don't know how to fish or something.
What kind of line that is?
This Mr. Crack. This monofilament. It's 8 pounds. Boy, I got it docked on it again. This is frustrating. And then right after I freaking lay it over the tree, not even 2 seconds later, I'm untangled, but couldn't do that while I was standing on the tree. Got a pole out?
Yeah.
Okay. right here, it's another tree right up under this tree that I'm on that's cross it, and it's some limbs and stuff. Every time I pull up in that little hole, I be thinking one finna get it. I don't get nothing right there. Man, this bass over here chasing all kind of stuff back up in this little grass and stuff. This flimsy rod, I hope I don't hook no real big fish. Boy, that would be something.
Well, Mr. Rich gotta be finished already.
Either that or he ain't coming, cause he ain't, I text him.
You text him?
Yeah, I text him to let him know that we down here and that he should park in that drive, cause my truck is inside. And he hadn't responded. Yes, sir, Mr. Black. Yes, sir. Thank you, Lord. Hey, you. Hey, Judge, you know how long this lake's been here?
I know over 50 years.
Really? Golly.
Yeah. My dad used to fish over here when he was a kid.
For real?
Oh, yeah.
Dang. Over 50 years, y'all, this lake been here. Said his dad used to fish here. In the boat. I was catching a lot of them male black crappie the other day, and they were starting to get darker and darker. That's a good sign, yeah. Them black crappie be getting real dark. They be in the spawn real good then when them jokers get real dark. I don't know. I don't know, you know, if they tie it off because to mark like the boundary or whatever for when they start developing. No idea. You might get bit right there. Coming right through there. Plus, So you know this thing is probably so full of fish, man. Probably a lot of fish need to be taken out of here. That's why you see a lot of these crappie, they only around 9, 8 to 10 inches long.
Yeah, super fly ass.
I'm feeling the nighttime down here. I bet you minnows would destroy them big crappie. I fished the lake in Noonan one time, which is on the south side. And it was smaller than this one by a little bit. But you go there, you would catch 10-inch crappie all day long. 9, 10-inch crappie. Soon as the sun went down and it was right at dark, you start catching them big ones. And them big ones would only bite the minnows when it got late in the evening. That was weird to me.
Doing a lot of night fishing with minnows.
Mm-hmm.
Lake Okeechobee.
One day I'm gonna go fishing on Okeechobee.
Off the lake, you know, it's called, that place was called Port Miyaka.
Port Miyaka?
Something like that, yeah. Right outside of Bill Glade.
Okay.
Actually, it was in Bill Glade. I'm just scared of big ass alligators.
Yeah, that's
huge alligator.
Man, Florida got more than alligator problems now, man. You know, they done found anacondas and cobras down there now. Bro, I'm like, Florida is a whole nother planet.
Big ass alligator.
Yeah, they got
a bunch of them.
I don't know, man. Y'all Florida people, y'all something else, man. I never forget the interview Deion Sanders talked about the day he got arrested for fishing in this little pond by the airport in Miami or wherever he was in Florida. He said that was the best fishing day of his life. And during the interview, they was like, you grew up in Florida fishing, and it's a lot of alligators in Florida. They was like, you wasn't scared of alligators? He was like, as long as you can see him and he minding his business, he ain't gonna mess with you.
Yeah, that's true.
Hey, I'm sorry. I can't trust the alligator for nothing. I ain't even finna give them that kind of test. I'm sorry.
That's true. They ain't gonna mess with you.
That mug ambush you.
Just don't fall in the water.
I'm telling you, when I was in Pensacola at school, man, I was fishing up in them canals. Bro, you know how them tunnels go from one side of the road to the other, them canals.
Mm-hmm.
Man, bruh, I was standing up on the road and I'm chunking a jig down this freaking canal and it's woods on both sides. And you know how the water down there always got that tannic rust looking color?
Mm-hmm.
Man, I'm pulling my jig up out the water and I just happened to pay attention. Right below me, I was like, it's got to be some bluegill. But his gator was sitting right down below. I said, oh no, I got to go. And the same thing happened in South Georgia, man. My buddy, we went down there to go hunting, and he took me to this little lake where we could, that his son's granddaddy owned the property, and we was making sure our guns was on. He had a pontoon boat he had turned into a dock.
Mm-hmm.
We was sitting down there doing our thing, and he had his feet hanging off the pontoon, right? And the pontoon was probably, the way they had it on some kind of dock piling. It was like the base of a pontoon. And it was out the water about 3 or 4 feet. He had his feet hanging down, and I walked over there to get a cigarette from him. And I looked up, I said, Trey, get up now, get up now, get up now. He said, what you talking about? He looked and saw what I was talking about. I didn't have to say another word. And he about hobbled. Bruh, that mud beat me back to the truck so fast. I was like, man, what the heck? He was like, yeah, man, we see gators down here constantly. Because Dr. Lee got a pond on his property. Probably about, it's smaller than this whole area. But his trash son them be down there catching the alligators out of the pond, taking them back to other places down there.
Yeah.
Yeah. They come in, he got like his pond, he grow the fish in, he got a feeder, and he turned the feeder on, and them fish get big, and them alligators be in there getting them fish. And he was like, every time they see an alligator, they catch it, and they go put it in another area, get it away from the pond. I said, no, man. Nah, I'm sorry. That ain't me. If I see a gator, I just hope it's during hunting season. Gator hunting season, because I love eating gator, but I don't want to deal with none outside of that. I would be hoping.
You ever taste gator before?
I love gator. I eat gator a lot. Have I touched the gator?
I mean,
I love gator. I've held a gator. Sean, back home in Alabama, he used to have this gator. We used to call him Face. And he got him when he was a little bitty baby. But the North Alabama cold proved a little too much for him.
Yep.
He ended up dying. He had that gator for like 2 or 3 years. And when he first got him, that little joker was about 18 inches long. And before he died, he got up to about 2.5-3 feet long. And he was chunky. But he didn't make it through them winters. He had outgrew the aquarium he had him in. So we had kept him outside where this little pond thing was and had it to where he couldn't get out of it.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess
I think
that,
my shot one.
You did? Man. I don't even know what I'd do. If I shot one, I'd be scared to walk up on
it. I had a little 38.
Enough to sting him and make him get on?
He was swimming. I think right after the hurricane.
Oh, man.
Water's pumping.
Yeah.
I was out there every day.
Mm-hmm.
And she's like, pow! That's like a...
Oh,
he
man.
Jumped out the water and hauled
it. Yeah, I don't play with gators like that, man. Every time I go to Louisiana, man, we go to New Orleans. We got some friends live down there. They where they from down here. They live here in Georgia now, but we go to New Orleans, man. Every time. What was that? You got it? You know the bass? That's a better one than the last one. Hey, you catching them on the red one.
And worms.
You up here trying to catch some brim and you catching large mouth. What's that one? About a 2 pounder? Two, 3 pounder?
Not really. One half.
He's pushing two. He may be over. He might be two. That's two decent ones you done caught. On the red worms.
On the red worms.
Every time we go to Louisiana, I always watch out for gators crossing the road. They, down there, I didn't see it as much in Florida, but Louisiana, when you driving down the interstate, man, they got these fences along the side of the interstate because the gators will come out of the swamp. And you gotta watch out for them suckers. They got some giant gators down there too, boy.
Well, they number one in Florida, if you can believe.
Louisiana?
Yeah, Louisiana number one for gator. And Florida number two.
You know them gators all the way.
I think they farm them a lot down there.
In Louisiana?
Yeah,
I believe they do, because, you know, they got an industry down there. They have gator hunting season. And them guys be catching them gators and selling them to restaurants and whatnot. That's crazy. Down there, all kind of seafood sell. Gators, turtles, you know, they big crawfish farms and stuff. Them swampy places, man. I don't know. It's something about
that. I saw an article the other day about turtles.
You did?
Yeah. I guess Indonesia or something, they eat sea turtle.
Sea turtle?
Yeah. They,
I've never had
like
sea
eight
turtle.
People died from eating it.
Really?
Yeah. They had some kind of parasite or something.
Oh, dang. I ain't never had sea turtle, but I've had plenty of snapping turtle in my life. I love a snapping turtle.
It had some kind of parasite.
Dang.
And they ate it.
Sea turtle. Yeah, that just, yeah, I won't be messing with no sea turtle then. Yeah, they definitely not biting today like they were the other day. Crazy how 2 days make a difference. And then we supposed to get a bunch of rain in here Friday again. I'm gonna have to bring one of my bass poles down here with me and fish specifically for bass fishing. You saw them two bass I caught that one day on Rich posted. Mm-hmm. He didn't know how to use. And now you up here catching them on red worms. If I had a black plastic worm, I'd probably tear them up.
I got a plastic worm.
I don't wanna catch no bass.
You don't
wanna
catch no
bass? I want these crappie. And if these big brims keep hitting, I want some more of them. Might have to try to one spot we always be at back up there, you know, where it's deeper, where that one big tree.
Yeah.
When we first come in, today is done got slow down here. The other day I got tired of missing and catching. I really want to go in them coves like where that guy walking to though. I want to know how he come in on that side. I know they had talked to him. Jared them was talking to him. I don't know what all they said to him, but.
They said he caught a 4 pound.
Yeah, I heard that. Catching them bass on red worm remind me of when I was in California. It was just one lake. You got another one.
Yeah.
Oh, stick this guy. It was just one lake a partner of mine took me to out in East San Diego. And you had to watch out for mountain lions out there. But we went out there and I thought we was going brim fishing. Because we stopped at this little bait shop and all he grabbed was 2 boxes of Nightcrawler. And I said, bro, we're going to get them brim. He said, no, we're going bass fishing. I looked at him. I said, you'll see. So we get out there, right, and the water was gin clear. But you could see these big old bass on the bed. And what he was doing was he was wacky rigging the worm, just hooking it right through the middle of the body. Mm-hmm. And he just toss it on the bed and let the worm just wiggle it. Them bass will suck it up because they want to get it off their bed.
Yeah.
Every time, man, we were putting a hurting on them. So I said, now this is too easy, man. That's way too easy. That was the first time I had ever bass fish with a freaking Nightcrawler. You know, yeah. Intentionally trying to catch them. I've caught plenty of bass before on worms unintentionally.
Big bass is kind of on worms.
For real?
You'd be surprised.
Everything, eat a worm. I've caught saltwater fish on Nightcrawler.
I don't know about saltwater.
But I was catching calico bass in San Diego, man, over by SeaWorld, man, just tearing them up. And when my kids went. Okay, hold on, I gotta be quiet for this. Thank you, Lord.
There you go.
When my son and daughter was young, we would go over there and we would go night fishing. And there were these bridges, and you could pull down under these bridges. And, man,
thank you, Lord.
We would use night crawlers. And, man, them sons, the only thing about a night crawler in salt water, it die quick. And it start, like, getting this crazy texture to it. But we was over there catching calico bass, with freaking night crawling. Calico bass, and then we would catch kelp bass, and caught a few small halibut on night crawling. It was crazy. I said, okay, now I see everything to eat a night crawler. Stand on this one for a minute. Stay low. And they biting real slow today. You got tired of jigging, huh?
Yeah, I can go back.
Something told me to bring two poles. I had my little girl out on the field the other day. Monday, as a matter of fact, when I came down here, I got one of them little kid fishing poles, a little Zepco 202, that I taught my oldest two how to fish with. So that pole is almost 30 years old. And I have my little three-year-old out there teaching her how to cast it, because I wanted to bring her out here. She would have been doing good Monday evening. All she'd have had to do was just drop it in the water and be a kid, not keep it still. She would totally fish up. But she didn't, her interest wasn't there just as much. She throw it out, and she, you know, she ain't really coordinated good, so she couldn't reel it in good, right, and everything. And she kept saying, I want to go fish in Alabama. I was like, okay, we going to Alabama soon. I need to call them over there and see how the fish doing. Cause they've been catching them, but the lake's still real muddy and the creeks are real muddy. I got two or three of my classmates that guide on the lake, and I be reaching out to them, and they be letting me know straight up, hey man, they on, and nope, they ain't doing nothing. You went up to lock them down?
Yeah, after you told me about the white bass, but they wasn't doing that.
They had ran on, huh?
Yeah, they had ran out.
Them crappie probably biting up there to lock them down now, but see, that's on the Coosa River. That is right there. That is the river. So right now, ain't no telling what that water look like, because it's always muddy anyway. Mm-hmm. But after all these rains, ain't no telling what it's doing right there. Sometimes I hate going to the locking down, because it be so crowded with people. Man, you be shoulder to shoulder standing up there on that lock. And then when you get on the ground and try to get away from people, if you catch one fish, everybody come over there. It's crazy. It's like when you in Florida and you on either one of them piers or on the jetty, and you start kicking, everybody come. That's how it be at the locking down. They probably killing them up at Mud Creek right now, though, bro. I like to be back up in Spring Creek in a boat right now, or either on foot. Because I know a lot of them big slabs done made they way up in there. Had to have. The good thing, I think, when I looked at the Weather Channel, I don't think it's going to get too much colder with this rain coming. I think it's still going to be kind of in the 60s. So that might not hurt them as bad.
Might do some exploring at West Point.
West Point?
This year. Yeah.
I got to get down there. I've never fished West Point. I've never fished with Dowie. I never fished Eufaula. I really don't want to go to Eufaula because there's a lot of doggone alligators in there too.
What's up?
Yeah, Eufaula is down there close to Dothan, right on the Alabama-Georgia line too. It's close to Florida too. Tell you another place got a lot of alligators, South Carolina. I'm gonna stay down here in the dark. I'm on. Can't, I thought we'd come and catch a whole bunch real quick, but they ain't hitting the same today. I'm about to change the style of jig I got. I think I'm gonna keep the same color, but change the style. But this is one of those triple tail curlies, which I think I'm gonna go to. Something different.
Oh.
Y'all, they ain't doing what they've been doing lately. They is slow. They're hitting my favorite color, but I'm gonna go to this favorite color. It's like a shad with a really long curly tail, but the tail got a lot of silver fleck in it. It's black and chartreuse also. I forget what it's called. It's a Bass Pro jig, but the label is worn off. I've had them so long in this tackle bag, but I'm gonna try it with my same color jig head, and maybe they'll get right with this fleck. This fleck might cause them to react a little different. We're gonna see. Only thing I don't like about these particular jigs is the tail is so long that a lot of times the tail get bit off. But this is the one I'm using. That redhead black chartreuse with that fleck in it. We're gonna see if that changes anything. Hopefully they'll engulf it like they've been doing the curly tail. We'll see. Where you threw out at, Mike?
Right here.
Oh, okay, I see. I'm gonna come that way in a little bit. I'm gonna see if I can. Oh, Lord.
Y'all pick up any more?
One or two.
We ain't doing nothing with them today.
Man.
One here, one there.
Man.
They hitting on them minnows or on jig?
I ain't got minnows. He just using his minnow bucket to throw fish in.
Oh, I got you.
Everything I catch been on jig. He been catching largemouth, caught a couple of decent largemouth with red worms.
Oh, I don't doubt that. They caught the better one.
Yeah. Yeah. What was your biggest one, Mike? About 2 pounds, a little bit under?
That ain't bad. That guy up there that showed us all ago, he catches them on top water.
Oh, he bass fishing.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Did he tell you how he came in over there?
Uh-uh.
on there before I could even do anything. Oh, it just went under the water. I didn't even move it. And my line don't want to get right. Thank you, Lord. Whew. There go, y'all. Change jigs, and there it is.
Thank you, Lord.
That same thing happened the other day. I just threw it out there, and as soon as it hit the water, I threw, once my float hit, and didn't even make a move. My float just hit the water and kept going under. I like it when that happens. Hopefully, that's a good sign. Pull that jig down good. Tangling up, catching fish while I'm tangled up. Oh, I missed that one. Dang, that's two bites come up there. Don't let me come over your line. All right, y'all, I'm gonna go ahead and end this right here, but I'm back out here today. If action get hot and heavy, I may start it back up, but I'm gonna go ahead and end this video. I appreciate y'all watching, all the new subscribers. I'm gonna tell y'all like I told everybody else from the beginning. I'm not doing this to be a YouTuber. I just love showing people what I do, and I love seeing people that do the same thing. So, if you got a phone, man, throw a video up one day. Let me see where you fishing at, what you catching. Let me see you gardening. Let me see you cooking. Let me see you hunting. Anything outdoors. Let me see you cut your grass, whatever. Because I video all that stuff. But in the meantime, y'all, this is Stephen, Bama GA Outdoors. God bless. Have a great peace.